Outland is a game none too shy about its influences, exhibiting equal reverence to the Belmont clan's castle-crashing, candle-whipping legacy and Treasure's frenzied polarity play, Ikaruga. It's an unusual pairing to say the least, but the resulting product is a fun, if a bit fleeting, proof of concept, showing that opposites really do attract in the end. The conceit is simple. Outland's world comes swathed in two distinct colors, with your intrepid hero soon finding himself able to switch between them on the fly. Matching an enemy or obstacle's hue renders you invincible to shots fired, but you have to take on the opposite color in order to dispatch foes. It's an interesting dynamic that works exceedingly well with the game's host of dangers, big and small. Traditional approaches in combat and platforming take on an entirely new light, given body by some genuinely creative scenarios, sure to test quick minds and fingers alike. The treacherous wilds are steeped in shadows, but your hero comes to brandish more than just a sword. Coming up triumphant against the game's challenging boss fights yields a number of additional moves, from slides and staggering shoulder charges to bullet-absorbing energy shields and laser beams. There's an appreciable sense of progression as you learn to dismantle obstacles with your newfound powers, even encouraging a bit of backtracking with teleport points scattered across the map. But as large, mysterious, and beautiful as Outland's realm may be, Zeeb's it ain't. The worlds play more like large, linear levels than the massive, interconnected ecosystems you see in Metroidvania games. From the viewpoint of seasoned vampire slayers and bounty hunters, the scope falls a bit short of expectations. Expect an average run-through of about 6 hours. Players wishing to wrench more time out of Outland will find it scouring each corner of the wilds for hidden concept art and unlockable co-op challenges, which pit you and a partner against a throng of specially designed levels separate from the main campaign. The inability to play these challenges locally offline, however, is an irksome omission, and there isn't much else to delve into apart from arcade-style remixes of the game's main environments. There's no mistaking Outland for its marvelous presentation or its curious conglomeration of elements, which quite possibly amount to the freshest take on action platformers in a good long while. At 800 Microsoft points, it's a journey well worth taking.